What is going on, guys? Eternal Scopes here, better known as Jake. Today I'm going to be bringing you a tutorial how to make a simple logo. If you didn't watch that video where I made a speed art, this will be the same video. Well, not the same video, but this will be a different logo or something. But it's a very basic logo, but looks good. So as you can see in the background now, sorry about that steam pop up. But as you can see in the background now, that logo I made is pretty cool. So I thought, you know what, I'll bring you a nice little live commentary. Sit back, relax, have a cup of tea and watch the rest of the video and enjoy. Before we get straight into it, drop a like if you think this video is useful or helpful. Please subscribe to us for more daily content. And yeah, so let's get straight into it, guys. So what programs you need for this are Photoshop and Cinema 4D. You can get Photoshop for free from the trial. Just download Creative Cloud, Adobe Creative Cloud, and you can always get a crack or something just to crack it, so you don't have to pay fully or get it for free and that. I'll probably do a video about that soon. And with Cinema 4D, just put Cinema 4D R13 pre-cracked or R14, depends on what the computer is. If it's 64-bit like mine, it'll be R14. If it's 32-bit like my old one was, then it'll be 30 R13, something like that. So let's get straight into this, guys. So I'm on Photoshop now. You want to make a new folder and go like click on file, then new, then width wants to be 1080 by 720 pixels. This just gives you more of workspace just to make the logo. So once you've done that, just like if your clan begins with any letter, you just want like, I'll just do a B. Actually, I'll do an E. So that's a Y. Just change the colour to anything you want. And text. For this, you can have any logo. I'll put a link to the font in the bottom in the description. So the font I'm gonna be using is. I use this nice little one. It's called. If you want this one, on the font, go to Techno Hideo. It's called Dark Tech LDR, or there's more like this. So once you've done that, put it into the middle of your screen like that, and press Control T on Windows. On Mac, I believe it's Command T instead of Control. So once you've done that, just drag it as big as you want it, because we'll be drawing around it anyway. So yep, right, apply. Once you've done that, I was just rushing into it then, just click this little bit here and click apply. Then you'll know if you've got a good Photoshop, because everything will look like mine. And you just have on the side like this little pen. It might be selected on one of these, just simply just right click with your mouse or a trackpad or something and click pen tool, make sure it's selected on that. Then if you want really straight lines, just simply just go zoom in, then go back to that tool there, then grab the corners, so get the corner, and as you can see that's not straight. So what you want to do for this, Control Z, just simply drag that into there till it's straight, and don't do it down like that because it will mess up. So you press Control Z or Command Z, and it will curve like that for some reason. So there. This is obviously not going to be as straight as I wanted it, but oh well. So when it's in Cinema 4D, it was going to be in two parts, but I'll show you when to get into that, to get into the 3D bit. And you'll have to get materials as well, but I'll get into that once we hit that stage. So as you can see, that's not straight, so press Control Z. I normally spend about an hour on a logo, but this is because this is a quick video. It's gonna not take long. So once you've done that, if you've got any separate bits like that, just simply go like that, then once you've done that, simply just go to File, Export, pass to Illustrator, then make sure sometimes it'll be selected on Document Bound. Don't do that because it'll go corrupt. Just go on Work Path, okay, then save it where you want it. So I want it in my desktop, so I'll just make a new folder quickly. So I'll just call it YouTube Tutorials. I'll probably use this folder as well, just to do the tutorials. So I'll put E logo tutorial, or actually I'll call it simple clan logo so what's done that, simply just go into Cinema 4D and that, just go to open, go to that folder where you was, well, where you saved it, so YouTube tutorials, simple clan logo. Yours will look like I have a little Photoshop symbol, because I've got After Illustrator, sorry, it comes some that form for some reason. So there you go guys, that's the logo. Just simply click on there and put it in the corner here like that. I'll probably show you how to make a simple intro as well. We're using this logo. Then once you've done that, click on this little circle bit there and press plus. Then as you can see here, sorry about that guys, hold in on this little like circle in the square, hold on it with your right, I believe, left key, or on your mouse, and click extrude nerves. Then get two of them, because you need two of them. Ooh. I don't know what happened there, but oh well, there we go. So yeah, we've done that. Then simply, once it's open, a little plus there, just drag it up until the arrow faces down on each one. So there we go, as you can see there. And you can just delete that bit. Sometimes it, like the caps, it don't normally do that. So if it don't say any of them, like it did there, if it don't say any of them, object and that, just simply click on one. Then just press control and or command for the second one. So there we go. So what you want to do is to make it 3D. You want to just look around to see how much. Just drag it into the corner like that, and I'll put it on about 80. Or actually, I'll put it on 120. There we go. So yeah, that's on 120. Then after that, go to caps, then fill it cap. Twice, then set this to 4 or 3, depends. This just makes the lines more smoother, as you can see, like the corners are not more smoother. And you could just simply just move this a little bit where you want it. So I want it quite nice like that. Then after you've done that, just group these, so control G. Sometimes it don't work, so you'll have to right click and go to group objects and it'll say null. After you've done that, press Ctrl C, V, and it'll copy it, like that. Then, what you want to do is make this, what, about 10 smaller. So, go to Object, so make it about 100 actually, if you put it on 120. Drag it like that, and put this as much as you can in the middle. As you can see, that's not really in the middle there, so, should be there. There we go, that's in the middle. So I'll just bring it out a bit, so it just stands out, not that much, because that just right, same with that, just drag that out a bit. There, so it just gives it like a little border. Right, once you've done that, this is what I was on about earlier, you need the materials. You can make your own by just going to create new material, but I like that you can just download them. So once you got them, you go to File, Merge Objects, and then I believe it should be on my desktop. I'm not too sure. Yeah, there. It should say 4D or something at the end, L1B4D file. Simply just click on that. Sometimes it don't work, so or you could like. Sometimes it don't work, so you can just get like a Lightroom that sometimes comes with this. I can't remember where I got this Lightroom from, because I've had it quite a few times. So to make this look good, I just want to add a bit of lava. Don't worry if you get this like little white bit, it does come off, don't worry. Yeah, it'll just once you render it. So if I just quickly render it now, okay, you should be able to see it. It's not very fast at rendering when I'm recording, but it's really fast when I'm not recording. So as you can see there, it looks really good now. Don't worry about it being too big, you can just like zoom it out there and you'll see the whole aspect ratio of this. So yeah, so that's rendered out, just click stop calculating. And yeah, so I'm going to go for like a little... I'll probably go for purple. It's nice. Or actually, I'll go for this nice little blue for the background. And for the front, I'll go for a nice little red. Just to separate the colours a bit. And you can always add a colour correction if you want. If this glitches up like that and you can't see this sort of thing, simply drag that up to the top there and go to the sky. Change the colour to white, because if what we're going to do later, sometimes it don't work. So make sure you don't have a light when you make sure if you have a dark bit instead of that blue, make sure the background's light. If you have a dark bit, make sure that's light, yeah, and if that's light, make that dark. So so that's simply logo done. So just quickly render that out. I believe this one's called the phase thing. So there you go, you can see it's done. I don't really like that colour, so you just alter it around as much as you want. So I wanna put that and a bit of blue. Let's see what that looks like. Oh yeah, that glitches out sometimes. Yeah, you have to put this there. Right. Just copy that into the bottom. That there. So, what not actually up there. So, just quickly render this out. So that's looking really quite nice. As you can see, it's got like a little 3D effect. That you don't really need the 3D effect, but it looks good. So once you've done that, just go to this little cog bit here and put this as 1080 by 720p. Make sure it's selected pixels, not points or whatever. Then just click save, then save it as whatever you want. So I'll put A for YouTube. Then make sure this is selected format PNG. It's different when you're making an intro, by the way, so just thought I'd say that. So I've done that. Now this is where Photoshop comes back in. I'm just not going to say that. Then you go to File Open on Photoshop. Make sure you don't close this down from earlier. If you have, just load it back up if you need to. So I'm just going to quickly render that back out again because I didn't... It didn't save or whatever, so yeah, just quickly render it out. Intros do take ages to render out, so when I do the intro, I'm not gonna actually keep the video recording when it renders out, but I'll probably just show a preview at the end of the video, so you'll be alright. Yeah, so once you've done that, there we go, nice little logo. Plus these light colours don't always come out light, sometimes come out dark. So yeah, there, E for YouTube, there we go. Just simply just go to this bit here, and yeah, I'll be back in a minute, guys. I'm just gonna just stop the recording and bring it back. So guys, I'm back. So right, what you need to do now, once you've done this, got rid of the background and everything, simply just go click there. So you can just move it around there. So move it wherever you want. If you want, press Command T or Control T on Windows, and tilt it if you want. So I just wanna right, put that there. Then just go on the internet, search for a nice little background that you want. Cause this is the E. Background I'll use. I'll just use a nice little speaker. I'll probably do like a Call of Duty cinematic summit. Actually, I'll use one that I've already got. So if I go to File, Open, then search for my images. Oh, it's a bit laggy there, my mouse went. Sorry about this, guys. My mouse is breaking, I think. So just go to my editing, GFX Pack, Part 2, Textures, Planetary Scenes, Space 2. You've probably seen, this is what I put in mine. Like, because we've got a purple effect, this looks really nice. I'll search for Call of Duty Cinematics Soldier. Oh, that glitched up. Sorry about this, guys. I've just got a little... Yeah, I can literally trace this logo. Just save that, guys. Sorry about that. So, yeah, there we go. That's lovely. That I love my space stuff. At the moment, I didn't used to like these cinematic, well, these like little GFX packs, but love them now. So, yeah. So once you've done that, just get that, apply, just use that as a background if you really want to. Just bring that up here. Then what you want to do is get a background. I'll probably put this up for download in the description below as well, because these are like. Unless you like to have a shine and that. So just get I've got it in my desktop somewhere. Editing. Actually, no, it's an internal. ABC Eternal's personal logo, there we go. We've got background beach. Yeah, there we go. Got that nice little shiny effect. Alright, just unlock that. Bring that into there. Command T or Control T. Put that in the background, right in the background, apply. Put that at the bottom. Click on the layer where you've got your image. And go right click and go to blending options. Then put the capacity to quite light, like that. Then there. Simply just go on that, images. Sorry about this, guys, my internet's been really slow today. To say it's on like that many bars, whatever, it's quite good. So, want a nice little one. This is for a personal logo, but That can just be the clan logo, like a little letter like that. This part would be like personal logo bit. So I'm just gonna try and get a COD Ghost one. Yeah, I use that one there. Make sure it's quite big as well, because I know Photoshop like alters the resolution a bit, like so it's not blurry. But sometimes it will just mess up. So I just want to get rid of that now. So I'm not going to save that. Just to make this performance a bit faster. You don't have to get rid of it, guys. So, that's not going to work. No. Actually, you could just put a girl in if you really want to. So just go file, open this one. Could use this one. I got sent this by a friend on Skype. This guy wanted me to put it in his for his like logo bit. So I'm just gonna stretch that out. Press apply. Duplicate this. Bring this to the bottom, just over that layer. Then bring this above your logo. Then click layer, create clipping mask. Then right click on this one here where it says the copy, blending options, and the capacity, whatever you want. So there, you can see it a bit. So just mess around with this a bit just to get used to it. Just like put the blending down a bit. You could always get rid of this bit at the back, like so it looks like a room full of smoke, quite good. Then once you've done that, you can always just move this if you really wanted to, so it like could go anywhere, which is pretty good. Once you've done that, Control T, I'll just move this around a bit more. Yeah, that'll do. Apply. Then this is where your text comes in. So I'll just put eternal. So make sure this is above all the layers as well. Sometimes it, otherwise it won't work. Actually, it needs to be above this copy here, like above everything. So. Needs to be above that, but don't want to work. Wait, one sec guys. Text. Yeah, there we go. So because we've got a certain font that we use, True Lies, I'm going to use that. So this, I love this font, it's called True Lies. There we go. I'll just call it Scopes. Let's just bring this around a bit, just to make it look good. Okay. Yeah. So once you've done that, click on your logo, click blending options, drop shadow. As you can see, it brings back a little shadow. Make the size as big as you want. So I'm gonna just say about that big. Spread about that. Outer glow, make that a bit black, bit size. You could always put like a stroke bit on it. Sometimes that makes it nice, like stand out a bit. See there? This looks pretty nice at the moment. Control T. You could always do this for the same as well. So if I just like duplicate this picture, bring it on top of the scopes, click layer, clipping mask. So as you can see, it's on the little scopes bit now, which looks pretty cool. Then just simply change the color of the text. So just go to color overlay. Right. Make this have a drop shadow, plus in the stroke capacity. Don't have too much because sometimes it can just wreck it. So Control T. And if you're a graphics designer like me, you want to like get your name out, like who made it. So just put. Just put your like little logo like thing there. So sorry about this guys. So made by Alright, it's done the same as earlier, so just do that. Text made by make this font not the same as the one, because you want the other bit to stand out. So yeah, just put I've put my next favorite one, ABCD, flex it titling. Just make that a bit smaller. Made by eternal scopes. And just put this, like, use the arrow keys just to move it around a bit. Then press Control T. Make sure it match, like, make sure. Oh, alright, if I just quickly. Right, make this white. Just so it doesn't, like, stand out too much, so it doesn't ruin the logo. Press Blending Options. Press Drop Shadow. Just add a bit of a drop shadow. Leave it like that. Add a little stroke bit. Make the capacity a bit like not too in your face, and there you go guys. You can put this anywhere you want, like could be up there, down in this corner, or just in this corner. So I'm just gonna put it, suppose, about back there. Or you can always get rid of the made by bit, just leave the by, just to, so just put by there, by internal scopes. So that's it, guys. This does really stand out. It looks really, really nice. You could always just like make this as much as you want, like, because that stands out now. You can just make the capacity of this even more. So if I just like quickly change that, just to make it look a bit nicer. Wrong one, I think. Yes, this one here, blending options. You could always make that fully if you want, but so just make it just a bit lower. So yeah, guys, that's it. That's made by me, Eternal Scopes. So I'll just move this up a bit more, actually, just to. So yeah, that's it, guys. You can turn that around as much as you want. So yeah, guys, thanks for watching. I'm Eternal Scopes. You've been watching my video, and I'm truly honoured if you watched it to this end bit. So quickly just click the like button, put in the comments what you think, support this video and subscribe for more tutorials in the near future. And I'm Jake, and I'm out, and I'll see you in my next video. Thanks.